What's on TV?
You know, it just started.
Carbon is the basis of life on Earth because almost all molecules in the body contain carbon. Carbon dioxide is circulated among the atmosphere, oceans, soil, plants, and animals. The carbon level in Earth is maintained by a natural recycle process which is called carbon cycle. Unfortunately, since the Industrial Revolution, we human beings with the modern engines and technologies start to alter and disrupt the carbon cycle. We are releasing more carbon than the nature could recycle. In October 2013, the atmospheric concentration of carbon dioxide has increased to 395.15 parts per million compared to the pre-industrial assumed value of 290 parts per million. While we are burning fossil fuels to create energy, carbon dioxide is produced. Emissions from vehicles, from manufacturing industries, and from power stations, have increased the concentration of carbon dioxide in Earth's atmosphere. More heat is trapped and leads to rise in global temperature. Then, we have melting of ice caps, that cause rise in water level, increased extreme weather, spread of diseases, and change of ecosystem. So, how to deal with these significant problems? Integrated Environmental Services has developed carbon-positive reduction technology that breaks the carbon dioxide bond with only about one-third of the energy in that bond by pre-processing the carbon dioxide. The technology has performed consistently and successfully in the lab for more than 2 years. It is ready for field demonstration. Microbial fuel cell would be another solution. Anaerobic microorganisms could be used to clean up the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and at the same time produce energy from waste. Researchers from University of Massachusetts Amherst have engineered a strain of electricity-producing bacteria such as Jobacter sulfuridescens, that can grow using hydrogen gas as its sole electron donor, and carbon dioxide as its sole source of carbon, just as plants undergo photosynthesis. It is great to have these technology been implemented, but in the meantime, what we can do now is carbon capture and storage, CCS. CCS is a process of trapping and separating the carbon dioxide from other gases, transporting this captured and compressed carbon dioxide, and storing this anthropogenic carbon underground. The highly impermeable cupric and geochemical trapping mechanisms would prevent the carbon dioxide from escaping to the surface. CCS allows for a brighter intermediate future, as we are able to continue lighting up our houses.
What's this? Carbon in the environment. So boring.
Boring or not, this is what happened to our Earth right now.
Yet people don't realize and take it for granted. Actually, there are a lot of simple things that you can do, you know?
Like what?
Like...
carpooling. Cycling.
Hey, that's it. Why do you drive? Why cycle with me?
Recycle.
Stronger than a stone? Oh, I want it, I want it! Hey, roommate!
Let's go Queensway tomorrow, I want to buy a new handphone!
What? You want to buy a new handphone? Okay,
your drawer. See my drawer? Hey, how then? I want a new handphone. I want iPhone 6. Let me help you guys. In the recycle box. Okay.
Reduce meat consumption. Energy saving. Growing more plants.
Hey, why are you looking at me like that?
What?
No matter lah. Hey, I'm so bored. Let's go play badminton.